Hi guys, I'm Scott McGregor. I play Detective Mark Brennan, of course. Thanks for sending in all your questions. I'll try and do my best to get through as many as I can. And just a little warning, there might be some spoilers in here. So if you don't want to hear the answers and you just want to watch and see what happens, I guess look away now. So Natty asks, how come you're not dead? Yeah, good question. Mark, I guess, had to stay safe in witness protection. And so I guess we decided that we had to tell a couple of lies to keep Mark safe. And so that's, I guess, what they did. And I guess it worked because, you know, playing off that I was dead, the people that were trying to find Mark obviously would no longer go looking for me. Margie asks, how has Mark come out of witness protection? Well, again, you know, being in witness protection, I was there Mark was there to stay safe. And there was one particular police officer who wanted Mark dead, basically. And so something happens along the lines, which you'll hear about when you watch. This particular police officer goes away, which allows Mark to come out of witness protection, which I guess is why he's back. Michael asks, when you arrive back on set, who will be the first person to spot you? Well, when Mark comes back into Erinsborough, there happens to be a solar eclipse, so it goes a little dark. And Kate happens to look over and thinks she sees Mark, but she's not quite sure because it's dark. So again, keep watching and you'll see a little bit more. Emily asks, what's the best thing about being back and how did you feel when you were asked to return? I guess the best thing about being back is just seeing the whole cast and crew again and getting to work with them again. You know, you make this little family of friends who I absolutely adore. And, you know, I was really sad to leave. So I guess the best part is just, you know, when I walk back in there, everyone's got open arms and they were absolutely fantastic and such a great bunch of people to work with. I can't tell you how much fun we have on set. We're constantly laughing in between takes. So, you know, it would be a really hard job if we didn't have those people. So I guess that's the best thing. And being asked to come back is just amazing. I never thought it would happen. You know, when I left the show and I wrapped, you know, I shed some tears, I'll be honest. Yeah, I got a little upset and you think it's over. So coming back is really, really nice. Lauren asks, which scenes were harder to film, the sudden departure or the return? It's a really good question. I think the scenes in the sudden departure were probably harder, mainly because, you know, for Mark it was obviously really sad. And for me in real life it was sad because I knew I was leaving the show, which probably helped with my acting because I was really sad. But it was long hours. It looked sudden, you know, on screen, but it took a long time to film. And it was all real time. So there was a lot of little things that you, I guess, as viewers, you know, probably wouldn't have seen unless you were there behind the scenes. So it was tough. And, you know, as an example, Ash Brewer, who plays Kate, spent basically a month or two bawling her eyes out and being upset. And so you can imagine turning up to work from 7 a.m. till 7 p.m. in that state. I can't thank Ash enough for the time and effort that she put in for that storyline and how amazing she came across. Was just incredible. Milan asks, if you had to redo your whole Neighbours run all over again with your current knowledge and experience, is there anything that you would do differently? I don't think so. I mean, it's a really good question. I don't know. I don't think so. You know, when you turn up, you don't know what to expect. Neighbours is a very well-oiled machine, so if you don't keep up, you're going to get left behind. You know, it's one of the fastest-paced show in the world. You know, we film 6 episodes in a week, so it's quick. And, you know, if you're not ready on set, you're going to struggle. So, you know, I don't think I'd do anything differently. I love my time there, I love the people, and I love my experience, and I learnt a lot, gained some great friends. I guess that's all I can ask. Amy asks, why did you leave? I was on the show for basically 11 or 12 months, so it wasn't long, but I turned 30 pretty much the week that I left Neighbours, and I guess I got to the point where I thought, you know, you get to points in your life where you think you have to, I guess, move on and create new opportunities for yourself. And, you know, I have goals and stuff. I'm actually living over in Los Angeles at the moment, where I am at the moment. And, I guess I wanted to give it a go before I got any older. And there was an opportunity for me to stay on for a long time, but I decided against it because, I mean, as I said, I'm not getting any younger. So I just thought it was a good time to leave.